Class, class.
Yes.
All right, so lesson 14.2 is on drawing and measuring angles. And this tool called a protractor is what we use to draw angles, and we can use it to measure angles. Okay? The first thing they ask you to do is to draw some angles. The angle is drawn by using these degrees. And there's one thing you have to know about angles before you can draw angles using a protractor, and that is the three types of angles. All right, the three different ways to identify an angle. One is acute. What does acute mean?
It's less than 90 degrees. Less than 90 degrees.
Correct. Less than 90 degrees. A right angle.
Ooh. I found it.
A right angle, Katie?
Measures exactly.
Yeah, equal to 90 degrees. And obtuse is, what would be left?
More than 90 degrees.
That's greater than 90 degrees. Now, what does an acute angle look like then? Autumn.
What?
Oh, get away.
Okay.
Okay, that's not helping you to concentrate. What does an acute angle look like?
Acute angle? Oh, it's kind of like the angle sign for the things.
Alright, good. Yep.
Like the first one.
So in between here is less than straight up. Alright? And a right angle is
straight. Perfect.
Yes. Cindy?
A perfect L.
Yep. And there will be a symbol when you're making 90 degree angles, because it's very difficult to make a perfect L or to make it exactly perpendicular, it's called. And so they use this box symbol to mean that even though it's maybe not exactly 90 degrees, it's supposed to be. Okay, so anytime you see this box on an angle, it means treat it like a 90 degree angle. Or treat it like a right angle.
It looks like this.
Okay? And then an obtuse angle is wider than 90 degree angle. So this part right here is wider than 90 degrees. So that's helpful because there are two sets of numbers on here. There's two sets of numbers on the protractor. And so depending on when you look at the angle, if it's obtuse or acute, you have to know which number to use. If you are drawing a 75 degree angle, you have to draw it based on what's called the baseline. So we have to have a baseline first when you're drawing an angle. Okay? You see that? So first draw a baseline.
Where?
On number 4. Draw a baseline, and then use that baseline to mark the angle. Okay? Now, there's two 75s on here. There is a 75 here. And there's also a 75 here. Oh, wait, no, that's. Yes, there's also a straight angle, which is 180 degrees. Yep. But for measuring and drawing angles, we don't need to know that.
There is one.
Yes, there is. So as I was saying, there's two 75s on here. One here, which is at 75 degrees, and one right here, which is at 75 degrees. So which one do you use? Well, is 75 less than 90 or greater than 90?
Less.
It's less than 90. And so we have to use the one that is closer to our baseline. Okay? And our angle is going to this thing is really hard to use on this board, but I'll try. Because you can see then, once you've marked the spot, then you turn your protractor. Oh, I can even shrink it. Cool. Then I turn my protractor to mark where 75 degrees is. You see that? So first draw a baseline, then put your protractor on the baseline so that it's centered with the center or zero. Then mark the degree number that you need. And then draw the line. Yeah, what you have to do is you've got your little tiny box, but you've got a big protractor. So you mark a spot up here. I can do it right here too. Mark a spot right here. That's 75. But then when I draw my line, I only need to connect the dots. Like that. And then just draw your line this big. Don't draw the line to connect it all the way to this dot. Just draw it right here in the box. Okay? So you can mark a dot at 75 way at the top of your protractor, but when you're drawing the line, you just need to draw it in the box. Okay? Any questions? Do you understand? So you put this on. Line up the dots. draw the line.
This is
so then this is 135 degrees.
Number 12.
I did 12.
What are you doing?
The whole sheet.
I didn't explain anything. I'm not even explaining stuff.